in the circle below, central angle GOH. So central angle GOH has a measure of 3/2 radians. What is the length of arc GH? So let's define some variables that'll help us manipulate them a little bit easier. So where is central angle GOH? This GOH, it's this angle right over here. Let's call that theta. So let's say that theta is equal to the measure of GOH, of angle GOH. Now, they're asking us, what's the length of GH, arc GH? Well, arc GH is this right over here. And let's call that S. So let's let S be equal to the length of arc GH. And they also give us the radius is 6 centimeters for this circle, but let's just call that R for now. So the radius is equal to 6 centimeters. So the first thing that we should think about when we're dealing with arc lengths and radians is how do angles measured in radians relate to arc length? In particular, how does an angle measured in radians relate to the length of the arc that subtends that angle? And in this case, the length, this arc right over here, arc GH, subtends angle theta, subtends central angle GOH. So what's the relationship? Well, the definition of radian measure says that an angle measured in radians is the ratio between the length of arc that subtends that angle, so S, and the radius of the circle. If this was a unit circle, then it would just literally be equal to that arc length. If it's not a unit circle, or I guess in all cases, unit circle or not, it's the ratio between the length of the arc that subtends the angle and the radius. Now, given this definition, really, of what a radian is, let's see what we know and what we don't know. And we can manipulate this however we see fit. We could multiply, you could see this written as if you multiply both sides of this by r, you get r theta is equal to s, or another way of writing it is you could get s is equal to r times theta. S is equal to r theta. And we could have solved this equation or this equation, but for this problem, this one's actually going to be a little bit useful because this is the unknown, the length of GH. We want to know what this is. This is the unknown that they're asking for, and this explicitly solves for the unknown. So it's essentially solved it for us. So what else do we know? Well, we know the radius. We know the radius is 6 centimeters. We multiply that times the angle in radians, which is 3/2 radians, and we are left with, so S is equal to 6 centimeters times 3/2. And so we are left with, this is going to be equal to 6 times 3 is 18 divided by 2 is 9. It's going to be equal to 9 centimeters. And we are done.